Jeopardizing the safety of your fellow officers. Folks, we have to face the facts. There are rattlesnakes out there, sometimes on both sides of the fence, and we have to protect ourselves. Today I want to talk to you about 10 ways that someone can jeopardize your safety in the corrections business. If you like this video, please subscribe. Gary York, True Prison Stories. Thank you for watching. 10 ways. We're going to run through this and try to do about less than a minute on each one, and you can work the rest out yourself in your own mind and see what you think. Number one, jeopardizing an investigation. Okay, you are a correctional officer, may even be a correctional officer sergeant or above, it doesn't matter, and you know there is an investigation going on in your prison regarding gangs. And you have learned that there are outside agencies involved. It's not just your inspector general or your internal affairs and your prison management, but you have some high-powered organizations outside working the case. You have a couple of people in the prison that know about it because you have to have safety, of course, when you have informants. So you've picked out a couple of people that are going to be keeping an eye on things. But the information leaks out, as it does many times, and you decide to take a piece of paper with inmates' names. Now, on this side is one gang's name, names of inmates from one gang, and on this side, names of inmates from another gang. And you put a rat, a picture of a rat next to each name. Oh, that way you feel comfortable at night when you go to sleep. You don't feel as if you said anything verbally. And somehow that list of inmate names with the word rat next to it gets out to the inmate population. Well, the inmates figure things out, and now there are not only hits placed on inmates in your prison, you may have started a riot that will get officers hurt. You have also instigated a hit list that now contains a couple of fellow officers on the list. So when you think you're playing funny games, you are jeopardizing the safety of your fellow officers. And who in the world, in their right mind, as an officer in uniform, under the oath of the correctional officer, who would do that to your fellow officers? You know, we're going to jeopardize the safety and security of the entire prison by doing things like that. So that's number one on the list. Crazy but true stories that really happen. Number two, inmate love. We know that when you have a relationship with an inmate, female officers and male officers alike, there have been cases documented when the relationship is broken off. The inmate becomes irate. The inmate is angry. Now you yourself, the dummy who fell in love with an inmate, is in danger, but now you've placed other officers in danger. How? When you go home at night after your shift, you just broke off with the inmate is upset, and he causes trouble on the next shift. It results in a use of force, and an officer is injured. You did it, yes, because you had an inmate relationship. That's number two. Number three, and I have my list here, let me look. Number three, not backing your fellow officers in need. Cowardice. I did a video on that the other day. When you do not respond immediately and help a fellow officer in need, you are placing them in danger, grave danger. You are a coward. This does not work in our business. You must go. Enough said on number three. Number four, talking about officers' private lives and private information. Whether you speak to other officers yourself about your private information in front of inmates, or whether other officers speak about you and your private information in front of other inmates, it's very stupid, very dangerous. The inmates listen. They don't say a word. They gather all the information. It's their intelligence gathering method that they use to manipulate staff members. And you're giving away private information on yourself or other officers when you're gabbing and blabbing and rumorizing with each other about other officers. Don't do it. Don't talk about other people at work. Keep your mouth shut. Be professional. Don't jeopardize your fellow officers. Okay, that was number four. Number five, overriding officers in front of inmates. Mainly this is for supervisors, but it can be for senior officers and fellow officers as well. Never correct officers in front of inmates. Take them to a private room. Don't even correct officers in front of other officers. Do each officer separately. Why is this jeopardizing the safety of an officer? Because you belittle the officer in front of the inmates. Now the inmates do not respect that officer. They may not do what the officer tells them. They may laugh at the officer, and it creates problems. Should be enough said when you just state the title, do not override officers in front of inmates. 90% of us know what this does already. For those of you that don't, or those of you just coming into the business, remember that. We've seen supervisor sergeants do this. Don't do that. Don't do that to your people. Do not override an officer in front of an inmate. That's a big no-no. Number six, a biggie. No explanation really needed. Bringing contraband to inmates. When you bring contraband to inmates, you place everyone in danger. Bringing them cell phones so they can coordinate escapes and gang hits. Bringing them drugs so they can get high and get rowdy and hurt your fellow officer. Come on. Do I have to say any more? Don't bring contraband to inmates. That's number six on my list of 10 ways to jeopardize the safety of officers. Allowing inmates to use your cell phone. Oh my gosh, come on. Yes, it's happened many times. Just me alone in 12 years, I investigated several cases of officers not bringing the cell phone in to give them, not bringing in other contraband, but breaking down and being nice and saying, okay, call your son, call your daughter. Manipulated by the inmate who says they haven't talked to their son or daughter in so long and they just need 1 3-minute phone call, and the officer breaks down. You're jeopardizing the security of the prison, becoming complacent, and committing a crime all in one. Enough said on allowing inmates to use your cell phone. Number eight on my list, falling asleep on duty, nighttime or daytime, 24 hours a day, I don't care when. When you fall asleep on duty, you are not observant to what is going on. Dangerous things happen when the inmates know you're asleep. And when you fall asleep and the inmates commit their heinous crimes in the prison or the jail, it may lead to an officer being hurt. Jeopardizing the safety of an officer by falling asleep on duty, yes. And on perimeter post as well. Falling asleep on duty and allowing an escape could not only lead to jeopardizing the safety of your fellow officers on the manhunt to recapture the inmate, but it can cause harm to our citizens. Enough said on number eight. Number nine, failure to keep inmates in line. Why? What's the big deal as long as they're doing something that's not bothering anybody? Keeping inmates in line, keeping them in compliance with the rules and regulations creates a safe environment. When you become complacent and just let the inmates run rampant, do whatever they want, hide over here in the corner, they're not hurting anybody. He's just doing a tattoo. That's happened. Inmates doing tattoo, that's illegal. We need to confiscate the contraband, the tattoo ink, the tattoo gun, and we need to write a disciplinary report on those inmates. But we have had people let it go because they're not hurting anybody. They're not causing any trouble. Makes my shift easy. Let them tattoo over there. Oh, those two inmates are getting it on over there. Well, you know what? If they're in there getting it on, that's their thing. I don't have to worry. It's not bothering me. Well, it can later on. Those things turn out to be time bombs that blow open and cause problems in your dorms or in your jail pods. So yes, keep inmates in line, follow the rules and regulations, and make them follow the rules and regulations. And number 10, yes, you knew it was coming up with me, failure to report corruption. Fear of retaliation from your supervisors is a big factor in that sometimes. Supervisors, please let officers report incidents. You deal with the incident the way you want after they report it. But do not retaliate against an officer who, by rules and regulations, is supposed to report corruption. Don't give them a hard time and don't be a good old boy group. Be a fair group. Be fair and impartial to all your officers. And take care of problems as they arise. And now that I've got that off my chest, failure to report corruption. When you don't report corruption, you allow it to build and build and build, and it turns into an escape, which we've seen so many escapes in the news and on television that were a result of not reporting incidents along the way, little incidents that turned into big ones. So please keep all these in mind. I wanted to keep this at 10 minutes. I'm going to be at 11 minutes when we're done, but about a minute for each topic. 10 ways of jeopardizing the safety of your fellow officers. And I know you can think of some more, so let me know of some other ways you can jeopardize your officer's safety. Thank you for watching Gary York, True Prison Stories, and please subscribe.